go over the same stuff that we went over on day one. Okay, so safety aspects, how the ranges run, the different target lines, the different lines, and things like that. You know kind of what to do and what the deal is, okay? We're going to go over the range setup, the different lines. Please stop laughing. The different lines and some of the safety aspects and things of that nature. So to begin with, we're going to go over the range setup, okay? Whoever has taken this class before can start by the first line. So we're going to have the waiting line, the shooting line, and the target line. So we have the target line. Up from that, we have the shooting line. The distance that we're going to start at until everybody can start hitting the target consistently is many yards. Five or 7 yards, okay? I might pick six. Okay. Sounds better? Okay, so we can go 5 to 7 yards, probably six. Okay, from there, the next line is?
Waiting line.
The waiting line is for?
People waiting.
Okay, the way I'm going to have the range set up, okay, there's going to be cones marked. You're going to have your individual lines, 5 lines, sitting down, okay, everything is going to be very structured. Okay, the reason it's structured, we have to follow these little rules that you might think is unnecessary because of the equipment that we're dealing with. Okay, dealing with errors, if somebody doesn't decide to follow the rules, people could get hurt. Okay, it's very important that we have everything set up and follow the rules accordingly, okay? So everybody's going to be in their single file lines, waiting at the waiting line to come up on the whistle command, okay? Between the shooting line and the waiting line, what is in between that space? How many yards and the equipment?
5 to 10 yards.
It's close.
Crap.
5 to 7 yards.
4 yards.
Oh,
okay.
Sorry.
From the shooting line back to the waiting line, that's 4 yards, okay? What kind of equipment are we going to have in between there?
The rack.
The rack, which consists of?
The
bows, okay? That's where we're going to have our bows. So when we come from the waiting line to the shooting line, in between there, you're grabbing your bows. If you have it, you do now. Everybody shooting pretty good, okay? So I moved them back. It's only like 2.5 yards. Okay, not a big deal. Probably going to move it back a little farther, okay? Because you are shooting pretty good. That's what it is, okay? You want to do challenge. Close-footed. You have the proper form, but you're just too close-footed, okay? So if we're standing like this, I'm going to open it up a little bit more. Second thing, follow-through, okay? We need to be ending up following through with our hand on our shoulder, okay? Proper follow-through. You can have everything in check. So if you're hitting to the right side of the target consistently, and you have your anchor point, your aim, and your follow through all down pat, you know that we need to change something and it's not in that process. Okay, so if we're shooting right consistently, you know that we're shooting proper form, you can say, okay, maybe we need to adjust this. Maybe we need to aim up over that kind of thing. Okay, those are the two things I want you to work on next. Also, for the last class, 2 classes, 6th and 7th grade, okay, I've had to lighten the poundage on some of the bows. It's too light for you. If you'd like it tightened, more hard to pull, just tell me. I have the tool to adjust it, okay?
Yeah.
Subdue.
Toes on toes. Okay. Toes on toes. Need them on toes to take care of our equipment. There we go.
Here, instead of grabbing down here where there's this much separation between the arrow, just grab right below it, okay? Because that's right there. Let's just kind of do it off center. So next time, get right up against the arrow, but not touching. It's going to give you more control.
Second group waits at the line. First group gets the arrows.
I like messing with the glass.
First group, are all the bows okay? Anybody need a tighten? Okay, hold on.
Good.